This Sunday, millions of Christians will gather to celebrate the resurrection of Jesus Christ. But the question is, did it actually happen? Did Jesus really rise from the dead? And are there any proofs? Can we actually prove that he did? Well, this week we're going to look at six proofs to the resurrection. The first one is the changed life of Peter. Think about Peter. He was a disciple of Jesus. During Jesus's last week, he's following Jesus. He's watching from a distance the trial of Jesus. Peter is in a distance, hanging out with this crowd, sort of watching and taking it all in. And this little girl comes up to Peter and says, "Hey, aren't you with Jesus? Aren't you one of his followers?" And Peter denies Jesus before this little girl. And then another girl comes up to him and asks the same question. Peter denies Jesus again. And then a third person from this group comes up and says, "Hey, you're a Galilean. You're with Jesus too." And Peter denies it. He puts a curse on himself and he starts cursing. Now, this is a coward Peter. He is absolutely afraid of his life. Think about it. That's Luke 22. Now, fast forward to Acts chapter 2. Just weeks later, when Peter stands up in front of all of Jerusalem and all these people from all over the world, and he shouts as loud as he can, "Jesus is Lord. He is risen from the dead. You need to repent and believe in him." Now the question is, what changed between Luke 22 and Acts chapter 2? What made Peter go from coward to courageous? The only explanation is that Peter actually saw Jesus rise again from the dead. He actually saw Jesus be crucified, put in a tomb, and then 3 days later, Peter saw the risen Lord and Savior. He touched him, he felt him, and he believed that Jesus truly was who he said he was, who is God and Savior, who died for our sins and rose again. So the only explanation to Peter moving from coward to courageous, preaching Jesus, even when it eventually cost him his own life, is that Peter saw something that changed his whole life. He saw the risen Lord and Savior. He saw the resurrection of Jesus. So proof number one is the changed life of Peter. If there was no resurrection, Peter would not have been courageous and preached. He would have just went on fishing.